Hello and welcome to Blizzard at Gamescom. Today is the very last day of the event, but we sure have a great show coming up for you tonight, as we do actually have some really cool behind-the-scenes stuff with the developers of Blizzard. And also we're going to talk to a World of Warcraft guild. It's one of the best out there in the world, and we have two of them here in the studio to talk about their guild, about raids, about Warlords of Draenor. So that's going to be really, really interesting. And on top of that, we of course have some other stuff, for example, contests, but we're going to dive into that later. Before that, I once more want to give you an impression of today at Gamescom. So this is just my gut feeling. I'm not sure if it's true, but are you maybe a Horde fan?
That's true.
Is it true?
Yeah, sans Warcraft 3.
Can you show us some Horde, like maybe a war cry or something?
Roar!
For Heroes of the Storm, and I found myself a Swiss guy. Have you had an exciting time so far?
Yeah, it was pretty good, yeah.
So throughout all those 3 days, have you been at the Blizzard area, or is this the first time now you're joining cool side of the halls?
No, we were on all 3 days. We were here on Blizzard, on the Blizzard side, mostly for Heroes of the Storm.
All right. So have you played Heroes already, or is this the first time?
It's the fifth time.
You guys came here for Heroes of the Storm. Is that correct?
Yes, it's the best game ever.
Best
I love this game.
Ever.
I was Friday here and today I'm again here. It's the best game ever. I play it for today all day long. It's my game.
You play Horde?
Only Horde.
Okay, that's good. Can I hear a Horde war cry from you guys? I do it too. And I'm pretty sure I beat you to it because I'm really manly. And that's why I asked. Because this looks like a challenge. Okay, 3, 2, 1.
For the Horde!
Yeah, I'm not even going to try to challenge that. That was a bad idea. And with me in the studio is the, according to this cue card, magnificent co-host. Josh, did you put that in?
I did.
Okay, nice.
Could you tell by my handwriting?
Yeah, it looks like a 3-year-old's should be yours, really. So it is the last day of Gamescom. How are you feeling about that?
I have mixed emotions. I don't want it to end.
Tell me all about it.
I have a lot of things to talk about. No, I don't want to go. This has been an amazing experience. This is my first year, like we talked about before in the other streams, but I think I'm going to sleep up in the rafters.
Nice.
I think if they can't catch me, they can't throw me out. So I'll be here till next week.
Yeah, I think that's...
It keeps going, right?
Yeah. No, so if you don't leave, it never ended.
That's what I thought.
Wonderful, yeah. Wonderful. So we have been broadcasting here from the Blizzard booth itself. The studio has been built right in here, so we have the best view of all of the views, right? And you have been running around today again, as per usual. How was your day? Was there anything special, excitement going on?
No, yeah, it was. I mean, well, first off, the fans are incredible, which brings me actually to a question. The guy you were talking to, did he go in line 5 times for Heroes of the Storm?
Yes.
He waited
10 hours in line.
If he
puts it all together, he was like, yeah, it should be 11 or 12
that's
hours.
So cool. That's yeah, I mean, that's nice. At the end of the day, the fans really made this happen for me. I'm so impressed by them. But anyway, yeah, so I got to talk to a lot of great people, and I was hoping to actually talk to that guy who waited in line 5 times in a row, but you got to him first.
I'm so sorry.
Yep.
I'm so sorry.
About that.
Now, we can talk about contests.
Yep.
I started talking about it in my intro, and I want you to continue. What do they have to do, and what can they get?
Okay, so once again, we've got tons of Twitter tweets flowing in.
We've got tons of Twitter.
Yeah, tons of Twitter tweets. BlizzGC2014 is the hashtag. You want to see how you guys are enjoying Blizzard at Gamescom. That could be at the house. That can be here. Just upload a cool picture, a cool tweet. Remember, this is the last day. We're choosing 5 winners, 4 runners-up, 1 grand prize. So get them in right now. And then at the very end of the show, we're going to be choosing them.
Yeah, so let's take a look at the prizes that people can actually get, because that's pretty amazing. It's such a long list. You see the daily winners who are getting really cool stuff, and also the runner-ups and the grand prize. That is actually the thing I'm looking forward to the most, because I haven't seen the finished artwork from Luke Mancini. I haven't seen it yet, and we will be seeing it later tonight, so I'm really excited for that.
I'm going to take a shot in the dark. It probably looks awesome.
Oh, well, we see about that. Let's see if you're right. I would assume so.
Yeah, I would hope so.
That's so nice of you. But we have had a lot of people tweeting at us, and there was some fierce competition for those prices, wasn't there?
Yeah, yeah. We're actually rounding the thousands mark. Matter of fact, they all just came in right now.
6,000. Oh, goddammit. Why did we announce that? Now you have to go through it again.
I'm so
sorry,
Josh. All of them.
But yeah, so one of the really cool things here at Gamescom is obviously people come to these kind of events to play new games. But of course, there is also games which they technically could already play at home.
Right.
Now, they still come here to play them here. And you actually have been going around and talking to people about this very thing.
Yeah, I thought actually I was the only one that does that. Right.
Nope.
I will fly vast distances to go to a convention and then play games that I already own. So that's where they came from. Like, you know, we should ask if I'm the only crazy one, but it's actually not.
Yeah, you must have been very happy about that, weren't you?
Ecstatic.
Oh. All right. Ecstatic. So let's take a look at what the people had to say.
So I got a quick question for you. Why do you come to Gamescom and play games that you could be playing back at your house?
Because of the feeling, yeah. You could say that, because there's so many people who want to play the same game, and it's awesome.
So I can meet or get new friends here for my friend list.
I think we gravitate towards the things that we're passionate about, and we want to, like you were saying, share it with the community and like see who else is playing our game.
I think meeting friends, you usually play online with all your friends, have a lot of fun playing the game, and finally you can go here, meet your friends, play new games, try new games, and just meet them. I've heard so many stories about people like meeting for the first time, and I mean, they can have a drink after the Gamescom and just relax a little bit. And I think this is just awesome. Bring everyone together.
Why do you guys come and play games at Gamescom that you could be playing back at home? Because I do the same thing.
We like Blizzard. Only for Blizzard we would do this.
Nice.
We like.
Oh, okay, all right. So it's a Blizzard exclusive. I can appreciate that. And are you enjoying the Blizzard booth too?
Yes, it's great booth. One of the best. I think the biggest event in the Gamescom.
Nice.
Great, great booth.
Awesome. Thank you, guys. Much appreciated. That was great. Very cool.
Thank you very much.
Thanks, guys. Thank you.
Who would have thought? We're not the only one doing that.
I'm so happy.
Now that I see so many, I can admit that I do it too.
Yeah.
now I'm cool with it. Now it's all right.
My only regret is that I actually wanted to jump in there and play Heroes. I mean, I know we've had like a crazy day, but I'm like, granted,
just
I play
cameraman,
it.
Can you please just, I quickly just want to, you know.
Can we do this later? I kind of want to get in line and play Heroes of the Storm.
No, I think that's fair enough.
Yeah.
That's fair enough. So now actually we don't have Heroes coming up. We're actually going to talk about World of Warcraft.
Yeah.
Warlords of Draenor. I said it already in the intro. We actually have some guests here in the studio. So I'm really excited about that. But before we actually bring them in, we're going to take a look at what they're doing. I'm talking about a World of Warcraft guild, TG Gaming. Those are the guys. They're really, really good as well. So we didn't get just someone. They have been here on the main stage showing everyone what they got. And we're going to take a quick look at one of their raiding trailers.
Blizzard!
Yeah, we started the project in the last year. My name is Konzi. Here we have Sky High. He's an elemental shaman. Tizzle, he is acting as healer. And Run Like Hell, he's playing mage. Neye, he's playing shadow. And Kyla is playing DPS warrior. By myself, I'm playing priest, heal, and discipline.
Is there any pressure? Did you ever get worried that you're performing in front of a crowd?
I don't know. I think there is a bit. The people are a bit nervous, but I think that's okay. It's all practice, let's say.
You guys do raids primarily, correct? So when you guys are setting up for a raid, how do you organize your team and like how do you make sure everyone's doing the correct stuff?
We have lots of communication things. That's very important for us. For example, we have our TeamSpeak where we meet each other and talk to each other. We have our website with a portal for our intern members so we can write about the bosses and stuff. So this is how we organize our team.
If you couldn't play World of Warcraft, what other game would you guys probably play?
I, for myself, play a lot of Hearthstone. I'm hoping to see stuff from the Heroes of the Storm, and this is what I'm interested to. So, yeah, the Blizzard games are really cool.
Thank you.
a lot going on the stage, and the guys from TG Gaming took the first Windrider right into our studio, and they're here now. I have Consti and Skyhai joining me. Guys, how are you doing?
Hello. I'm fine.
You're fine? Everything good? Everything good. Wonderful. So maybe, I mean, we already saw some stuff in the trailer right there, but maybe you want to introduce your guild a little bit to us and tell us what you guys are doing.
Yeah, we're playing World of Warcraft.
Figured that. Yeah. good start. I like it.
And we're number one in German when it comes to raid content.
Wow.
And yeah, that's what we do, is hardcore raiding.
All right, so hardcore raiding. What's your recipe to set up a raid and actually make it work?
What is a recipe?
Just what, like, how do you make it work? Why are you so good? Explain it to us. Like, what puts you on top of the others?
I think, we have very good players. They are very into the game. They love it to play it. And that's it. That is very important, I guess. Because if you don't love or like what you do, then you're not good in it. And other things are like, like the tactics and stuff for the bosses. You need to be, you have to let's say, there is lots of stuff to test and to think about it. And we have some guys who do this.
Oh, so you have theory crafters in the guild who sort it all out. That's great.
Wow.
Like, that's having those kind of people in your guild who take it to the next level, taking it that serious.
That's really cool.
That's I'm very happy there are some people like that.
I have a question for you guys. How did you all meet? Like, were you friends before? Did you come together online, or how did that all work out?
For me, I met the others online, and. Yeah.
Were some of the people friends before that already? Like, real-life friends? Do you have that in the guild too? Or is it just, like, people who have been recruited because they were really good?
It's normally people we know from the World of Warcraft. Mm. And I met Rocky, it's the guild lead of TG Gaming, on the guild before TG Gaming. He started build up TG Gaming. And then he asked me, and I said yes.
Well, good decision, I would
nice.
Say.
Okay.
How long have you guys been playing?
For me, it's since I think I played for 6 years.
Okay.
I started 6 years ago.
And you?
I started with the older content.
Okay.
It's, I don't know, 6-7 years ago.
Ooh, I got another one.
Okay, Josh.
I don't know why
you,
I felt
Josh.
Like I need to raise my hand. how many hours a day do you guys practice? And is it an everyday thing, or how does this work?
We start a test on the beta room, and then we are trying the bosses. And then when the content is coming out, we are trying it each day. We are training the normal mode each day with different chars. And then when the heroic progress, and in the next round then add on the mythic progress. Then we are going in when the server is up, and we finish when we are too tired to play.
So I'm taking a shot of the dark here. This is a huge commitment to be at this level. I mean, you guys are putting lots and lots and lots of time into this game. Yeah?
Yeah, we are playing the whole day when the heroic content is out.
That's cool.
So being able to play now on the Blizzard stage in front of so many people, does it make you feel like, yeah, it was worth it? Like, all the time we put in there, like did you expect that you once gonna stand on a stage like that and present your guild in such a way?
No.
Good. Surprise, you did. Well, that's great. Yes.
I even never expected to even get a German first kill or something like that. So it's awesome.
I mean, you're not only good in Germany. You guys are actually world rank 7 as well. So you are a top-notch guild. How does it look like with the content in World of Draenor? Do you think you're going to manage again when the expansion is coming out? Do you think you can keep that level up or even get higher in the world ranks?
That's a very funny question, because with the next raid content, because the 25 men and 10 men, they are mixed together into 20 men. And therefore, there are new guilds coming. There are, for example, other guilds coming back who played before. So, it will be much harder for us to get back in the top 10
but we try everything to...
Are you already having a master plan? So, I mean, now that we know when the game is released, did people already hand in their holidays notifications, like, okay, I'm taking off for this and this long? I mean, that's how we did it in my guild.
Oh,
so
really?
I don't know if you guys are doing that too. Like, is it, okay, progress time, everyone is taking days off from wherever they're working or doing?
I have a guild of one, so I'm pretty good.
Yeah, you're
at
out of this
management.
Conversation.
Okay.
Let's ask them. How do you coordinate that so everyone actually is able to make the time to go for those progress rates?
When we know that the Mythic content is coming out, all people, or the most people, try to get holidays, and then they have time to play.
All right. Well, that sounds perfect. Now, you already showed us some new content from Warlords of Draenor on stage. How did that go? I mean, I heard some wipes yesterday, I believe.
Yeah.
and I think I saw some. Was that expected, or didn't you try hard enough, or what happened?
It was the first boss. I think the people were really nervous. And after the first boss, we killed him. We just continued and did not wipe again.
Yeah, I mean, it worked flawless today, I believe.
Did you see the
crowd? Today was flawless, yeah.
Did you see the crowd when they were playing?
Oh, I couldn't do that
it
for
was,
my life.
But
I'd
was
be
packed.
Scared. I know.
I mean, like, I know that somehow our guys know how to measure this, but the crowd went all the way back to the other end. I think they said around 7,000 people were watching you guys play. It was awesome. And then anything you did, the crowd was just going crazy. So, kudos.
So, if we talk about the new content, which is coming up with the new expansion, do you already have an idea of how long it will possibly take to, like,
That's
beat the
hard
bosses?
To say, because the new content has two new raids, and they aren't released at the same time.
Yeah.
So, therefore, we don't... know exactly how long it will take for us, because if it's too long, and the problem is it's the new add-on is starting on November, so we might get a problem because of Christmas, and yeah, we have to see.
Ah, Christmas. It's great in-game. Opening presents in Orgrimmar, I never enjoyed myself more than that.
Nothing like working through the holidays.
And there is Santa in-game. I don't see them in real life, so, you know, it's a pretty easy decision there.
I now, like the snowball fights, by the way.
Oh, they're brilliant.
Yeah.
Atoric Valley snowball fights, they were my thing.
I crack up every time I nail someone in the back of the head with a digital snowball.
Nice.
It's the greatest thing ever.
Now, you guys, of course, have been raiding a lot, and that's why we're going to take a look at one of your raiding trailers right now. And we continue talking a little bit as well. How long have you been number one in Germany?
Since nearly 1 year.
Okay, so you kept that that place. Who was it before, do you know?
I think something like 400. Or 200? I don't know, I can't remember.
Which guild?
Yes.
I was playing in the guild before, which
okay.
was World 1. German 1, not World 1.
You just
German 1.
You just went to the next one. Who's going to be on? That's clever, I like that.
I think the last guild, I don't know, Genuine maybe was German 1, but I don't know.
Name. Now we know TG Gaming is number one.
That's
so
all
that,
I care about.
I was once about 2 years on the Allianz Guild Pulse.
Okay.
And we were two contents, German 1.
All right.
And TG Gaming is a guild. It's up to the last two contents. And then the second content, they could make German first.
How tough is the competition in Germany? Like, how many really good guilds are there who are playing on the top level like you guys are?
Yeah, there aren't very much guilds in Germany. For example, I think in the last tier we had, let's say, two hardcore guilds, TG Gaming and Genuine. And there were other guilds that were or are very good, but they don't have that much time to play. I think if they had that much time that we have to play, they might be much better than they ranked up at the end.
Right.
I think the biggest problem in Germany was that the most guilds were playing 10-man raids. And now with the 20-man raid, it could be more competition in Germany.
That's nice. That's good to hear. Are you looking forward to more competition? Is that
course.
Something you want?
More competition
of course.
Is
nice. That's good.
It's always good.
I can't even fathom coordinating a 20-man raid.
Well, back then we was 40 and we managed somehow.
No, I get
so
it.
I think 20 should be easy.
Large numbers.
Oh, God. I can't even count that high. How can I coordinate it? No, that's great. Well, I don't want to steal any more of your time. Once more, thanks a lot for being here, for being on stage, to showing us that amazing content from World of Draenor. It's been a pleasure. If anyone wants to know more about their guild, just go to tg-gaming.eu. Is that correct?
Yep.
Looks great. Oh, I'm good at memorizing that kind of stuff. Go over there. I assume you guys also upload videos of your stuff there. Yes, so there will also be a Warlords of Draenor content anytime soon. Once more, thanks a lot for being here, and we're going to be right back
now.
Yeah,
thank you too.
All right, and we are back again, and it's soon time for the daily updates, where we once more go over everything happening here today, and then I would say I have way too many cue cards, so I can just get rid of some of them, and we're heading into the daily updates.
All right, so we're going to find someone who wants to talk to us. Oh, look at them, they're not making eye contact. Come here, buddy. What's your name, man?
Benedict.
Okay, so it's the last day of Gamescom. It's Sunday. What have you thought so far?
We just arrived. I don't know.
You guys just arrived? Okay.
I don't know what the day brings. I'm going to see. It's very exciting. We as a group, we are interested in mobile games. Nice. And Heroes of the Storm and Blizzard.
I know you haven't seen much, but like cutting through the halls, what do you think?
Yeah, it looks pretty awesome.
Yeah.
I love Blizzard. Make really good games. Combine all my favorite games. I like it. Yeah.
And why did you say you guys came here first?
Because it's the best game.
What have you thought about Gamescom so far?
It's great. Yeah. It's my first year this year, and it's great.
What's your favorite game here?
World of Warcraft.
You're wearing a Horde shirt, I see.
Yes.
So I take it that you're a fan of the Horde.
Yes, I am.
I'm asking really stupid questions, aren't I? So it's the last day of Gamescom, it's Sunday. What have you thought so far?
I thought it's pretty great. Like, there's some good stuff. I've been playing the Blizzard games since 14, 15 years now.
So I'm going to assume you're going to come back next year for Gamescom?
Yeah.
Yes, I like it. Yeah, I hope so.
Are you coming back next year?
I don't know, maybe.
Maybe, okay. So that's 103% yes and 1% maybe, statistically speaking.
So we just looked at a little survey with visitors from the Gamescom, their thoughts on this year's Gamescom. We had a very successful time here with Blizzard. We had over 300 play stations where they could actually, not play stations, play stations, where they could just try out all the games. And that actually was already the first part of our daily update. But because I threw my cards away, I didn't know that, right? So let's just head into the second part, which should be about Heroes of the Storm. Now, there are a lot of aspiring teams here at the event itself. And one of them is a guild, or I see I'm still in the World of Warcraft, is actually a team called Coinflip. They're also from Germany, and they talked a little bit to us about what they're doing here in Heroes of the Storm.
Stitches is the best hero! I'm the support player of our team, so I typically play Uther or Malfurion.
I'm the Varian of the team. I am playing Arthas, Diablo, Stitches. I just try to push the people around.
And you guys play what game exactly?
Heroes of the Storm.
Yes, they do. Heroes is still in tech alpha. Are you seeing some stiff competition already?
Right now, the competitive scene is fairly small, but we still try to improve ourselves.
During matches, we really talk a lot, because communication is everything in Heroes of the Storm. I hope we can manage to establish ourselves at the top of Europe, at least. Yeah. And really to compete with all the other really good teams out there in Europe.
What's your favorite mount?
I love the direwolf.
That's the wrong answer. The correct answer is the unicorn.
No.
Oh, we're done here. That is the end of that interview. All right, guys, once again, thank you so much. Best of luck to you. It sounds like you guys have a really bright future.
And during our Friday broadcast, where we had Yong Wu here in the studio, one of the lovely guys from the development team of Hearthstone, we took some questions from the community, and one of those people who asked a question was actually Nimsh. And he asked Yong Wu, who is the best Hearthstone player in the development team of Hearthstone. And, well, Yongwoo named himself, and now Nimsh and Yongwoo actually met up to play a little bit and talk about strategies.
Hi guys, this is Sina and Nimsh, and I have a question, a very important question for Hearthstone developers. Who is the best player on Team 5?
Oh, you know, I thought I was going to get some curveball questions. This one's really easy. I am obviously the best player mm-hmm. in the team, actually.
You're probably also the most humble, I assume.
I'm also the most humble.
So there you guys have it. Developers and programmers practicing together, it's a pretty cool thing. Hearthstone's an easy game to pick up and a hard game to master. Believe you me, I'm learning the hard way about that last part. Very cool. So tell me, what were we doing here today?
You know, now I have a lot of pressure to go back and play my teammates, so I want to do a little practice round, and Nimsh is gracious enough to hook me up, so here I am.
Very cool. All right, let's get right into it then.
So we decided to do an autofill, which is you start with an empty deck, and then when you close it out, you can have the game fill out the deck for you. And it's, you know, at first we made it so that like new players can finish your deck very easily and help them get up to speed. But, you know, it's actually a really fun format for seasoned players to just pick a class, you know, autofill all the cards. And it gives you that kind of a combination, like Nimsh was saying, between like constructed and arena. And it can be really fun because you have to expect the unexpected.
When we go into like the mid game and late game, sometimes it can snowball, but it's really rarely. Well, I was able to make some kind of a comeback, so right now the situation might be pretty even. Even though we play autofill decks and we don't exactly know what's inside them, if we get Thought Steal, we can actually trade cards between our decks. So nice. It seems to be pretty exciting and cool.
Well, gentlemen, I'll leave you to it. Thank you so much for walking me through that. Guys, enjoy your practice. Thank you. All right.
When Blizzard is having a big event with a big stage, there's one thing which is for certain. There is going to be a dance contest, and we're going to take a look at the one this year.
Does it feel good to win? Damn yeah, baby! It's good!
And it's really nice to be here.
And of course, there's a lot of different people visiting at the event here, and we talked to a lot of them, but we also were looking for some special stories, and we actually got one for you.
All right, so which game are you coming here to see?
We want to see World of Warcraft, and Hearthstone.
What's your favorite game?
Hearthstone?
So who's better at Hearthstone, the father or the son?
I'm playing longer because I've got a better key.
And you didn't share with your son?
Sometimes. Sometimes. Yes, better key, and I'm playing longer, and I have some legend cards. But he is coming. He becomes better.
What do you prefer, Alliance or Horde?
Lieber Horde or Alliance?
Horde? All right, Horde. I see where this is going. Well, I wish you a lot of fun. Thanks a lot for joining me for the interview, and good luck playing games together.
Yeah, thank you. Bye.
Gotta love families playing together, and we met so many here at the Gamescom. It was absolutely brilliant. Now, that was already it from our daily updates. If you missed any of the news in this show or in any of the other shows, don't be sad about that. You can actually head over to the Blizzard YouTube channel and look at all of this, the broadcasts we had here again, so make sure to do that after we're done here. And now with us in the studio are a few familiar faces, which we already had here at the very first broadcast. So I'm very happy to once more welcome back Yong Wu, the game producer for Hearthstone. Of course, we once more have Matthew Berger, who is the senior level designer for Diablo 3. And that leads us to the last one, who is Josh Mosqueira. Oh, you're such a fanboy.
I'm always excited when these guys are here.
No, it was great to have you here the first time, so we just thought, you know, let's cram them all on the couch together and talk.
One more time? Just one more time.
Okay. Wow.
Right. There we go. That's the entrance.
All right, guys, Gamescom is almost over. How do you feel?
Awesome.
Awesome.
Yeah, awesome.
That's good.
Awesome.
Yeah, that's next question.
Done.
Bumper.
And we're over.
I mean, you know, this was my first Gamescom, and seriously, it blew my mind just how many people showed up. So many people showed up to play Hearthstone. You know, the game's available right now for free right now, and just all these, you know, wonderful players swinging by to play with each other and you know, swing by and play with me a bit. It's been amazing that they do that.
Has there been people who managed to beat you in Hearthstone?
Oh, yeah, you know, it's especially the couples that are beating me. So you have these two really cute couples sitting in front of me, and they're chatting with each other, and then they're destroying my face 5 minutes
That's
later.
That's nice. Enough being destroyed by couples makes you feel all the better. Right?
No, I mean, it's really cool to see, you know, like a couple play together.
Yeah.
Apparently there's a lot
of people playing the game together. I also saw a lot of people like giving other people advice, standing behind them. Now, guys, what has been your personal highlight this event?
So I think for us, it's just seeing the excitement around the Ultimate Evil Edition. I mean, talk about what a great way to sort of kick off the week when it's sort of launching on Tuesday, to see everybody playing on the same couch and just like the lines, like just how excited people are to get a chance to play Diablo 3 Reaper Souls on the PlayStation 4 or Xbox One is really freaking exciting.
I can't wait to play.
We should be playing right now.
Yeah,
we got a couch.
All right, let's get a TV in front of us.
Is that a thing?
Let's head over to the area.
I'm
there's
out of
couches.
Here.
Bumper.
Yeah, we'll be right back in an hour or so. Let's see. Now, Matthew, what was your highlight?
It's not as highbrow. I got to meet Lurky. That was kind of a personal thing for me. Yeah,
he's not even looking at you.
We filmed something together. We had a moment. It was awesome. So yeah, that was cool. That was very cool.
He's been around this event. That's actually.
What's the name of the one next to him?
Little Murguy.
Oh my God,
Little Murguy.
Well, you just hurt his feelings.
I'm seeing Lurky. I wonder who's the purple one.
Look at these dead eyes.
Yeah,
how can you forget about them?
Whoa.
That's a compliment.
Shots fired.
Which I love.
You know, Gamescom, it's a long convention, and he's a little tired towards the end of the
thing. Oh, that's it.
Sure. That's what I look like when I'm tired. My eyes roll back into my head.
It just goes wide. That's fine for me. So is there anything really crazy happening to you? Like, what was the crazy, weirdest thing? Or was everything normal? Josh, I know you have stories.
Oh, I have stories.
Right?
You start. I can think.
Sure.
It's
okay. One of the funniest things for me is when I was interviewing people, how more and more of their friends would start coming into the shot. So, like, at first I'd approach and they'd all run away. And then I'd say, like, no, I'm just asking you stuff about Blizzard. And they're like, oh, I love Blizzard. So I'd be talking to the initial guy, and then 20 of his friends are all of a sudden in the shot trying to get the microphone head by pulling it away.
That's nice.
That's never happened to me before, just FYI.
Oh, that's...
You know what? What was really crazy for me was just a number of players who approached us while we were doing developer signing, and they had so much amazingly cool, I don't know what to call it, like
swag
artifacts over the years. I mean, this one guy had a just giant Tyrael sword. I didn't even know we had that thing. I want that thing.
What did it make you sign? Like, is a sword the craziest
one? Yeah, like sword, t-shirts.
There was a cover from one of our server blades.
Yeah, a cover from
someone had one of the server blades?
The WoW server blade cover.
They're so cool.
Yeah, that was really cool. We got that signed. Just stuff I didn't even know exist that kind of enriches the Blizzard universe. And you know, the cool thing for me was over the years I've worked on a bunch of different games. So a guy would bring me the original StarCraft II: Wings of Liberty box, and I'm like, oh man, I worked on that 5 years ago. And a guy would bring out a Warcraft 3 box. I'm like, dude, like,
I was playing that game in high school. Like, I didn't work on that one.
Isn't it great how much stuff they actually kept? I mean, you have been talking to one of the cosplayers, and she actually told us she still has the booklet from the first ever World of Warcraft game coming out. Like, this little, really big booklet. There was, like, some actually artwork in it, too.
It was
like,
the
scribbly and everything. I still remember it.
The story doesn't actually end there. Like, that's when the bit ended. But then, afterwards, she took me back to her purse and pulled out the book.
Oh, she had it with her?
Yeah, with her.
That's so cool.
She's like, I bring this everywhere. I'm like, you're awesome. Here, beta keys, here.
Take them all.
Take them all.
Totally. I mean, if you look at the credits for any of Blizzard games, it always starts with designed by Blizzard. So, you know, just that's what, to me, that's the craziest mind-blowing thing is we come here and just the original vanilla WoW box people kept, you know, or the original StarCraft, not even two, but the original one.
Yeah.
You know, all the different artwork we did and figurines we made, and people, you know, kept them. And, you know, they bring them to us and they want to talk to us. And we have this really amazing kind of chance to communicate with our players and kind of for them to kind of show me things I've never seen before. That's Blizzard. That was crazy for me.
Yeah, I mean, I get to work for you guys, which I'm super grateful for, but I'm still such an incredible fangirl that I went down to the Blizzard shop, bought a few t-shirts and stuff, and then they gave me the bag where it said, like, Blizzard on it, and I was like, yeah, I'm going to hang that on my wall. It's going to look so good next to every calendar picture I cut out and put there as well.
I thought you were going to say you were going to try and wear the bag, too.
Yes.
There you go. Tank top, done.
Should work. Same size.
Free tank top.
Yeah. Yay. If they would have known, I would have charged. No, that's just great. Now, we had you in the studio, but of course, we also already showed that you are busy guys when you're not hanging out with us. Now, we actually just... to be annoying, we followed you around even more than that, and that's what we're going to show you, some Blizz developers backstage.
So what's it like working at Gamescom? It's fantastic. I mean, it's get a chance to come to Cologne, Germany, get to see all these great games, but it's really a privilege to be able to be here and show off the great Blizzard games, like, you know, Diablo 3 Ultimate Evil Edition, Heroes of the Storm, Warlords of Draenor, Hearthstone. It's just, it's awesome.
This is the biggest show in the world. You know, this is like if Comic-Con and E3 had a baby or something. I mean, this is really amazing.
So what are my thoughts about interacting and meeting with the fans? It makes all the hardship of making a Blizzard game totally worth it.
They really want to get to know you a little bit better. They want to take a picture with you. They want to talk to you a little bit, and it's always a positive, pleasant, fun experience.
Well, when we're going to do an autograph signing, they always say, hey, who would like to do it? You know, it's voluntary. Who would like to do it? Yeah. And everybody always goes, me, because it's fun. It's just... I mean, selfishly, it's just fun. You get to sit there. You get to go try and do a nice little autograph. You know, you get to say, hey, these people really care about the work that I've worked really hard to do.
You know, we're used to making games where we go off in the corner and we work on them for a couple of years and we bring them to people. It goes a whole other level when you actually are here, meeting them in person, seeing their reactions to the game, getting their feedback directly. I think that is probably, most inspiring part of this whole process.
Our fans come up with so many great suggestions for the game. I mean, you're looking at just the Ultimate Evil Edition. There's, like, for example, Apprentice Mode is something that our fans wanted, and they talked to us the last time we were here at Gamescom and said, it'd be really great if I can have a high-level character and a low-level character playing together. And we couldn't do it for the original Diablo 3 on console, but for Ultimate Evil Edition, it was one of the things at the top of the list. So this is the business center, so this is where the magic sort of happens. So what you're seeing back here is kind of like the Blizzard area. We get up, you know, we have breakfast, and the interviews start at 10 in the morning.
Alex?
Hey, Alex.
I'm Josh.
So we usually go from 10 in the morning to 6 in the afternoon, and the interviews are about 20 minutes long, right? So you just like, it's just one after the other. You know, usually there's interviews that are booked, you know, and they're sometimes double booked, and, you know, we try to get as many sort of press through these rooms. So you just like, it's just one after the other. You ask a bunch of really cool questions.
The costume contest judging was a lot of fun because really the quality of the costumes is unbelievable. I mean, I feel bad not giving everybody a perfect score.
My favorite part about Gamescom is just being here at Gamescom, talking about the games, meeting our fans. I mean, we're also fans ourselves. Like, we work on the games during the day. At home, we go home and we play them. Again, it's just being able to talk about our games, both to the press and to the players, and to see what they're getting excited about. Totally energizes you, and you know, I just can't wait to go back to work to be making more games. It's just a great time to be here.
So that looked like a few very, very busy days for you guys, but it also looked like you were all really enjoying it.
It's a lot of fun.
All right.
Really,
so I mean, how did you think this is gonna go down? If when you received the information, okay, I'm gonna go to Gamescom. Did you expect it to turn out like this big? Is there gonna be that many people approaching you, talking to you? Was that ever?
You know, you always expect that. You know, every time Blizzard puts something together, it's gonna be fantastic. And then you get here and you realize that your expectations were just blown totally out of the water. And not just because of the way the things are organized, but just seeing all the people, how excited they are, it's just really, it's like the highlight of the summer for me.
Nice.
That's cool. I got a question for you guys. So yesterday was the first time I got to see the cosplayers that close up. And I watched you guys judging them. And every single one of them I saw, I was like 10,
10,
10, 10, 10. How do you go about actually deciding the winners with that?
You know, Tom said it. It's so incredibly hard.
Yeah.
Because not just the amount of work that goes into it, but the artistry and the craftsmanship, it's just like they're all awesome, right? So having to pick the best is almost like having to pick, you know, which are your children get to live and which ones get to die. It's horrible.
I like that example. And you guys have multiple columns too, right? It's not just like...
Yeah, we have several columns, you know, accuracy and presentation. All we try and spread as many categories as possible,
yeah.
And then
yeah.
At the end, he has to do all the math. So that's why it takes so long to get the winners and the losers, because he's there by hand, because he doesn't want to use his phone, doing all the sums.
No, and then double checking
them.
Hey, why don't you use your phone?
Well, I mean, I'm a little faster. Just
so not only
hey,
is
okay,
he the
way to perpetuate okay. the stereotype.
Totally.
Not only
is he the best Hearthstone player, but he's faster than a computer at calculating.
That's impressive.
That really is.
That goes on the job resume.
I can add really fast.
I would even put that in a business card, really.
Yeah,
that's just,
I would
too. It would sell it for me.
Professional adder. Adder, you know, that's on my business card.
Play that on my business card. Yeah. Don't take that from me. That's all I got left.
Really is. That's
it. Well, you know, one thing I got to say is, you know, one thing I was disappointed by the costume contest this year was, why was there nobody dressed up like a Hearthstone card? So next time,
an actual card.
Come in as a Hearthstone card.
You know what? Next time.
I will give you all 10s. I'll tell you that right now.
There you guys go. There it is. In the inside track.
You'll get
track.
At least one judge to give you all 10s.
What's that? He's not going to Gamescom next year.
I have been removed from the panel.
There's like
you
an ejector button for a seat.
You will be removed from the show soon,
exactly.
too. It's just going to like, your couch is going to be pulled
like,
out
wait,
in a
no,
second.
No.
Yeah. By the way, when they try and pull the couch out, just hit them, because they've been trying to do that to me the whole show.
Now, we actually had a lot of questions from you, of course, from the community, where we showed them to you, and you've been answering them. Now, you are, of course, are not the only one who come up with really cool ideas, potential really cool ideas for new games. We've actually been around in the community to ask them what kind of games they would design. So let's take a look at that.
So here's my question to you. If you were a developer at Blizzard, what type of game would you make?
Okay, I would probably try to make a point and click adventure. Because I'm really into the graphic thing, I always love artworks and stuff and details. And in a point and click adventure, you can really look into graphic stuff. You have to search something, have to search for details.
What about like a, like a first person shooter?
Oh my goodness, no, please not. You want to see the person you're playing.
Something science fiction related. I love space battles and spaceships and all that.
While you were talking, I was actually thinking about a Kerrigan RPG. I would totally play that. I really would. That's awesome.
So I really like the type of game where you just play one character and have to flee from the enemy, and so I like that kind of game.
All right, so I got a question for you. Okay. If you were a developer for Blizzard, what kind of game would you make?
Hard question.
Don't run away, I'll just follow you. Okay. No, I'm just kidding, I'm kidding.
But the storyline of Breaking Bad just a little bit further.
Nice. Very cool, I love it.
First person action game, kind of like Heroes of the Storm, with like all the characters from the different games, but like a first person action game where you, like a team deathmatch kind of game.
Nice.
I thought that would be really cool.
Is there any characters from the Blizzard universe you'd put in it?
I mean, Garrosh, for example, would be really cool to play, like Chop with the axe and stuff, would be awesome.
Okay, he actually has had the best idea thus far. I would buy that game. Blizzard, I would buy that game. Very cool, thanks man. That was awesome, okay.
Alright, so we did get some blah. Right. It was nice talking about that. Now, back to what the audience said. We had some really cool ideas. What are you saying? Would you go for something like that?
Well, I think we're out of a job. Clearly, yeah. The ideas are.
That escalated awesome. Very quickly.
Yeah. They got hired on.
Actually,
after.
My badge just deactivated. I think.
Yeah,
so
right now.
Hey, still getting emails. No, but you know what's interesting is you know, we joke about it at Gamescom and we reach out to people and, you know, ask them to what do you think, you know, Blizzard's next game should be. But the fact of the matter is, like, all of Blizzard players are already designers because we pay really close attention to feedback. You know, I know Team 3 does this, a Diablo team. We definitely do this on the Hearthstone team. You know, what's great about a digital card game is we get all the data in the back end so we know all the cards they're playing, all the cool new decks they're coming up with. So, you know, through all of that, we're like, wow, people are doing stuff we couldn't even conceive of before. And, you know, to me, in many ways, all of our players, just by playing Blizzard game, they already become a designer, you know. And then beyond just the data we get, we go to the forum, you know, we even just kind of chatting with people while we're getting signed. You know, we get so much great ideas about, you know, what feature should we work on next, and how do we grow this game, how do we grow together as a company and community. You know, I'm just so grateful. Like, it, in many ways, it makes our jobs way easier. It makes it really clear to us a lot of times which direction we should be headed. I mean, we're gamers just like them. You know, we're all gamers, and to me, also, we're all kind of developers at the same time.
Yeah, I think there's so many features, both in Reaper Souls and in the Ultimate Evil Edition, that have their origins and they can be traced right back to the community. You know, apprentice mode, per player loot, adventure mode, all these things at some point had their genesis, you know, in either a conversation we had with one of our community members at BlizzCon, on the forums, or just the random emails or tweets we get. So, yeah, I mean, our community is very much a part of our process, and, you know, they inspire us and they challenge us, and it's just this great sort of dance that we do together.
That is so great. Now, when is the next big event? Where can people meet you up and throw their ideas at your faces?
So we have PAX coming up. I'm not going. Are you guys going?
We're going to be at PAX Prime. Uh-huh. Yep. But and BlizzCon.
And then BlizzCon 2014 is the place to be. It's in November. I mean, for me, for instance, it's going to be the best BlizzCon yet. And I think that's quite a statement. I'm not overselling it because BlizzCon every year blows my mind. This year we got the Hearthstone World Championship happening. We got $250,000 on the line. I mean, I can't wait to figure out who the best Hearthstone player in the world are going to be. Even at Gamescom here, we had a couple community tournaments happening. And those people, like the top placer is now going to the EU qualifier. And then if they come out on top there, they're going to come to BlizzCon Invitational for a chance to win $250,000. So there could be someone out there right in the audience that's going to walk away with a lot of money come November. And it's going to be exciting.
That does sound exciting. Now, guys, thank you so much for being here in our broadcast. It was lovely having you here, getting your insight, talking to you, and hear all those things. And of course, you can meet them again at the BlizzCon from the 7th to the 8th of November. This event is happening, and that's going to be absolutely amazing. We can't wait to see more of their work, their upcoming games, and everything they have for us. And now, of course, in every broadcast, we are actually giving away some really, really cool stuff from Blizzard. If you are participating in our contest. And this year we're going to do that. Yeah, no, this show, we're going to do that again. And for that, we're soon going to have Luke Mancini here in our show. He will actually showing us the artwork for Heroes of the Storm he has been working on stage. We're going to be drawing the winners, so I can't wait to do that. And we're going to be, that's going to be happening in just a bit. Back again, ladies and gentlemen, and we are back with a guest this time. The show is almost coming to an end, but not quite yet, as we have Luke Mancini, aka Mr. Jack. Thank you so much for joining us. How are you feeling?
I am doing amazingly. I've had an amazing time at Gamescom, and I'm feeling fantastic.
Yeah, so you've been drawing it on stage. How was that for you?
It's been a heap of fun. I do it at BlizzCon as well, and it's always a pleasure to get up in front of everybody. Normally, painting like that is a very sort of solitary thing, so to be able to show people what I do is fantastic.
How do you prepare for that? Or like, how much time do you put into preparation, thinking of what I'm going to draw and how it is going to pan out? Do you actually have to make a master plan, or are you just like, whatever?
I did a fair amount of planning. I did a few sketches, get the rough sort of composition ready. Make sure I know which characters are going to go where, how I'm planning to draw them. So there's a fair bit of thought that goes into it to begin with.
All right. So being an artist for Blizzard, is that a childhood dream for you? Was that something you wanted to be?
Yes, pretty much. Ever since I was very young, I knew I needed to do something artistic. And growing up, I loved Blizzard games. I never even really imagined that it was something that I could have done. Like, if I told myself 10 years ago that, oh yeah, you'll be working at Blizzard, that wouldn't have crossed my mind, but it is amazing.
I got a question for you, Luke.
Of course.
When we were talking
of course. Of course he does.
It's Josh, of course. When we were talking earlier, you were saying that you love drawing Terrans. Is there a reason why you gravitate towards those guys, or, I mean?
The Terrans aren't my favorite, I have to admit. The marine suit particularly is so complicated,
yeah.
And you have to get it right every single time you draw it. So getting all of those details in the right spot every time can, I wouldn't say be a pain, but it makes
really
it more challenging. I have to say I really love the Zerg more. They're the closest to
it.
My heart.
Okay.
They're the monstrous aliens. They've got spikes. They've got they're huge. And there's a lot of freedom when you're drawing them. So the marine suit needs to be the same every time you draw it, and the same with all the other Terran units. But the Zerg, you get to play around with it a little bit. They're evolving constantly. They've got new armor plating or new spikes or new gooey bits, and I really like to have fun with it.
That's cool.
It really is. And now, next up, we're going to actually show the drawing you have done on stage. Here it is.
Wow.
Absolutely. That just looks so cool.
That isn't.
Are you considering this a finished piece? Or is there something you would like polish up a little bit?
I actually think it is almost finished. I wasn't expecting to quite get it done while I was here, but I was pretty happy with the progress I made. So there may be a couple of tweaks. Whenever I go back to a piece that sometimes I think I'm happy with, a couple of days later I'll look at it and be like, I need to fix that or that. But it's pretty much there. I'm pretty much happy with it.
I love the Demon Hunter in the back, by the way. That's really cool.
Yeah, this is absolutely amazing. Now, we already chose our five winners for tonight's broadcast, which does not include the winner, or it may include the winner for the actually art piece, as we, again, every daily winner gets the chance for this art piece. Only one of them will actually walk away with it. Actually, they don't walk anywhere. They're doing it from home. That's the magic of this broadcast.
They have to walk here and pick it up.
That's, part of
it.
That's how we're going to do
it. That's in the legal.
So let's take a look at the pieces. This is how they enjoy Gamescom. And, of course, those are the playing stations.
Yep. Waiting to play Heroes of the Storm. Exclamation point. Fair enough.
They
I like his expression. Look at the guy on the right, by the
good.
Way.
Oh, meeting Yong Wu.
There you go. Very cool.
Yeah, meeting devs must be a very, very nice way of nice.
There's us.
We get the thumbs up.
We got the thumbs up.
I'm going to do that
we're
right
good.
Back at you.
Yeah, right back. Stranger with a thumb.
It could be anything, really.
It could be anything, yeah.
All right. Oh, see, someone is enjoying Gamescom with watching your artwork happening live on stage. That is just great.
One word, amazing, period. I like this person.
Yeah.
Fair enough.
So now, of course, your artwork wasn't the only thing we had on stage. There was a lot happening during the BlizzCon, I already said. Now they confused me.
I know, right?
Now, there was a lot happening during this event here at Gamescom, so we just take a look at that.
What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Joshua Z here live at Gamescom 2014, and we thought we would show you what it's like to set the place up. You could fit like three or four E3s inside of this. It's insane. So let's go check out what they're doing over here at the booth. Don't run. Do not run.
Here are like the PCs that will be ready to use. As you can see, they're all pretty much ready to set up. The way it's going to work is that each row will basically play against each other, and they'll play either the opposing row or the one that's literally on the same side. And that's pretty much it.
Thank you for the tour, man.
Of course you are.
A lot of the costumes that we have here, believe it or not, are actually something that people can put on. So that's just not a statue. That's actually someone can get inside that and win the costume contest. How cool is that? We're about to see the world premiere of our newest cinematic. How pumped are you?
So much. I can't describe it.
You know, this is the first time that I've actually been able to be at a premiere of one of the films that I've worked on for Blizzard. So it was a real high for me. It was super exciting just to see. I couldn't believe how many people were here. You know, I couldn't believe how loud the applause was. It was just, it was very, very gratifying. I mean, this is why we do what we do.
I want to introduce you very quickly to our audience.
You're the boss, you go first.
You're the boss. All right, so I'm Josh Mosqueira, game director for Diablo 3 Reaper Souls Ultimate Evil Edition.
And I'm Matthew Berger, senior level designer for also Ultimate Evil Edition, UEE.
He is the game producer for Hearthstone, and of course, first off, I want to know how he is feeling. Yongwu, how are you feeling today?
You know, this is my first Gamescom, and...
you can join that club, then.
Hey, there we go. Hey, we're going to start a club.
First-timer club.
Oh, I'm going to get a t-shirt.
Yeah, awesome.
It's going to be flannel.
Hook me up.
Yeah, yeah.
For Ben Brode.
Yeah, refreshing.
I feel like I'm sitting next to Ben Brode here, he's wearing flannel.
And I want to talk about interesting people in different clothing. Josh is not the only one who's kind of sticking out with that flannel style. So, yeah, just to take a few looks at it, this is it's incredible. We got pretty much everything of every universe from Blizzard in there.
I mean, what blows my mind is these people made this stuff from hand. I mean, just from scratch is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah.
And 3 weeks, a month, a year, their process differs, but look at this. Yeah, I could never do that.
I listened in on some of the interviews they did on stage, and the majority of them actually said, like, yeah, I've been working on it for like nearly a year and stuff like that. That is so long.
Yeah.
We had kind of the Expendables experience on stage yesterday as two old school StarCraft 2 players have been going up against each other. I'm talking about Whitedraw and Stefanu, who brought their A game on stage.
Das schreibt einmal 2:0 für Stefano. Wir
it's a pleasure, honestly, because it feels good to be in front of a crowd again, and feels like the good old times, let's say.
As some of you might know, Luke Mancini is one of the Blizzard artists, and he is on stage doing live drawings every single day. He's working on an artwork for Heroes of the Storm. It's absolutely amazing, and we've been grabbing him for a quick chat.
So I'm doing a Heroes of the Storm painting. It's painting a full five-man team. So I've got one of our new heroes, Anubarak, that we're showing off here. I've got Sonya, Brightwing, Vala in the background, and Abatha.
I just want to walk them right into here. Please take a seat,
wow,
if somewhat possible, with those lovely outfits.
I mean,
yeah, let's just applaud for that.
Wow, I mean, really? Come on. Wow. Wow. This, are you seeing this, by the way? That the
yes.
eye is are blinking
they?
And... Look at... Come on, right?
And we are back again, and we are about to announce the winners. But before that, I would like to ask you, can you reenact the almost
handshake?
Yeah, yeah. With Yong Woo?
Yeah, absolutely.
In case someone didn't see
so
that?
You just, I don't know what happened. We couldn't make hand contact.
That was so good.
And then we would reestablish ourselves and then go back to trying to shake each other's hands.
It was that was just brilliant. I really liked it. Okay. Now let's take a look at the winners of the winner at today's contest, and that was the Pure Dedication one. Look
there
at him.
Is.
He's been standing in the crowd watching your artwork coming to life, and now he will get a copy of it, a signed copy actually from you. So what a lucky guy.
Congrats. Seriously.
Congratulations.
Congratulations.
Thank you so much for participating, and that goes of course for everyone. Also, it was absolutely lovely to have you here. That's Luke Mancini, everyone. He is an artist working for Blizzard. He's also known as Mr. Jack.
Yes.
So make sure to look his stuff up. It's absolutely amazing.
It's incredible.
Now, Josh, it's been pretty okay having you here, too.
It's been decent.
I'd rate it 5 out of 10. Would potentially sit you here again.
B-.
B-.
That's
good. No, it was great having you here. Thank you so much as well.
I'm so grateful to be here. I love Gamescom. I can't wait for next year. This was awesome. And you were awesome, by the way. Like, you're a shining star in the night sky.
Wow.
Is what you are.
Did you read that in a magazine?
I did, actually.
Like, oh, my God. Yep. I got to use this today.
It was on the back of a fortune cookie.
Nice.
Yep.
No, that's great. Don't even know what to say to that. So thank
either.
You so much. And of course, also thanks to our viewers. You have been supporting us. You have been participating. You have been throwing out questions. And we absolutely enjoyed everything. And of course, we also enjoyed that you enjoyed the shows. Make sure to head over to the YouTube channel of Blizzard. If you have missed any of the shows, you can still watch them as a VOD. And that's already rounding up our night tonight. Thank you very much and good night.